A Jamaican high to everybody on this earth. Yeah, Jamaican high. Boy, had a bad night. It was hot all day yesterday. No wind blowing. I said, you know what? I can't sleep in my tent, man, with this rain fly. So I took it off. Guy wakes me up and says, man, it's gonna rain, gringo. Here, fix your tent up. I said, I'll be all right. He walks in the house. I look outside, man. Everything around me is white cloud. And I'm going, shit. So got up, put my rain tent on. That didn't get tied down. Good. You can see it. So, this was right here, and I flooded. I woke up this morning, this whole thing was completely in water. So, I got my marijuana seeds wet. And I don't want to do this. I gotta go planting seeds today. I don't want to. I don't have no soil. I don't have nothing good to plant my good seeds with. Hell yeah, I'm gonna grow marijuana in Jamaica. The law said that each person with the house, this is my house, that's my house, can grow up to 5 marijuana plants per person. So I just told the owner of the place, screw you, man. I'm going to grow my 5 marijuana plants, and then yours, and then his, 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 and then grow everybody's marijuana for him. Can't do it, though. But I'm going to try it. Fucked up day. I don't even want to make this video. It's a fucked up day. Oh, then I left my toilet paper outside. Not this roll. Thank God I had a spare. Man, everything's wet, man. I feel like a wet dog today. But this place needed it. Fuck how it needed it. It rained about 3-4 hours last night. Kept me up all night. But I'm used to not sleeping. Damn, look at the waves today. Yesterday there was no waves. I went swimming yesterday. I told myself I'd go swimming every day, but I think I'm gonna tell myself to stay the fuck out of the ocean, the sea today. It don't look too good. It looks like it beat the shit out of me. I got beat the shit out of yesterday trying to get back on the beach. Wave would come up there and slap you, push you on the ground, and then suck your ass back out in the sea. He was doing everything to stay where you were at, and he's just dragging your ass back into the sea. I can imagine what it'd do today. Take the little skinny white boy away from Jamaica's Black Island. Yeah. Well, it looks like it's gonna be an overcast day. Yeah, right. Blue sky above me. Oh, yeah. Oh. There's no city water today. Fuck me. Yeah, no city water today. So, hopefully I can find some water to take a shower today. Like I said, it's a fucked up day today, okay? I guess this is day 29 for me on Jamaica Island. Hell, I don't know. I can't count. I know it's Wednesday, June 2015, but I don't know what day it is. I don't have the faintest idea what day it is. 31st, maybe? 30th? I don't know. I know Friday is going to be the 3rd, so you guys can add up all those dates. So it looks like it's June or July 1st today. Yeah, I guess it is July 1st today. Sure is. I can still count. Well, July 1st, 2015, stuck in Jamaica. They said yesterday was the first day of summer yesterday, is what they said. And he looked at me in his blue sky and he goes, "And remember, Gringo, it's going to rain once in a while here. So be prepared." When I took off that fly, and I said, "Yeah, it's not going to rain tonight." Yeah, right. Rained pretty good last night. Some good thunder. Man, that was some badass thunder last night. Lit up the sky. Hear it echoing for miles and miles and miles. That was weird. You could hear it just crashing through. Man, it seemed like 100 miles. It seemed like you could hear that echoing back. Well, I just wanted to make my video. Like I promised you guys and gals, I try to make a video a day. I'm not gonna do too much. I'm broke. I have 1,000 Jamaican dollars to my name, which in reality, it's only $10, less than $10. I get paid Friday. We've been partying up all week though. Fucking drinking every day. I didn't drink yesterday though, but I ate a lot of cookies and candy to keep me away from the alcohol. I have 2 more days to get paid, so I'm gonna have to watch my P's and Q's for the day. That's life. It's supposed to get some fish. Well, this fish was supposed to come in yesterday. And the fisherman said he only caught 2 fish, 2 little ones. So, I think fish is going to be on the menu tonight for dinner, hopefully. And no, I have no money to pay for the fish, okay? So try to figure out how I'm going to pay for the fish then. Yeah. I get paid Friday. As long as he's not willing to have to go to town to sell his fish, he's happy. Well, I was going to go swimming today and show you guys I was going to go swimming, but yeah, I think I'm going to stay out of the sea today. Because it was calm yesterday. And it was kicking my fucking ass. Yeah, I can't imagine what that would do to my little white ass in the sea today. I am going to go swim out there. See where the breakers are at right there? See that? See that? See that? See that where the water's breaking right there? See it? Look at it. Look at it. Look at it crashing. That, they say there's a reef out there. You can swim out there and stand. And it's about to your ankles. Which in Cancun, it was the same way. Cancun, Mexico. So, my next swimming trip, since I know I can swim again, I'm going to go out there. But, you have to have fins. You're going to have to. Because that current will fucking take you and beat you up. If you have fins, you can get away from it. But that's the scary part. There's a lot of ways you can get your ass whipped on the coral reefs. especially if they slam you against them. It's not fun. Has it happened to me before? Not on coral reefs, but on a lot of lava rock. Yeah, I got smashed up pretty good diving in the Pacific Ocean and get slammed up into a rock and then get sucked back out in the ocean. And weird feeling too. To be sit there and just be swept away and there's nothing you can do about it except cry for help. Help me! Help me! And you're crying underneath the water. Yeah, everybody can hear you crying for help. I don't want to scare you away from the sea, okay? If I can swim in the sea, I know you can do it. You just gotta float. That's all you have to do. Just float. You don't have to swim. You just gotta learn how to float. Pretty easy to do. Just lay on your back, put your arms out there, kick your legs around a little bit, and you just float. You just stay out there all your day long. You all the time you want to. Got some avocados growing here. I'm looking forward for that. Got some nice rainwater today too. So we're gonna have some good avocados. And that's gonna be my avocado. And I bet you any amount of, I got some good mangoes to eat. But I bet you any amount of money, somebody stole the only one mango on this tree. Only one mango on this tree, and I bet you somebody took it. Yep, they took it. No, there it is. It's still there. This tree only grew one mango. And I'm just still waiting for it to fall. Well, enjoy life, everybody. You only have one life to live. Oh, and remember one thing in life. Love each other like the Justifiers do to have peace on this earth. No. Love each other like the hippies do to have peace on this earth, okay? Best advice I could give to anybody on this earth. And I need to find water for my water shower bag so I can take a shower today. Yeah, I need to take a shower. There's some water out there. I've been known to steal water before. Yeah. Boy, these trees needed the rain too. That aki. And these akis right there were drying up. And they were looking sick. I can't believe how fast water goes right into a plant and just changes the way they look. Well, maybe not. See how they're dry. Check it out. Look at, they're not able to open up. They just don't, no moisture in there. Look how skinny these are. Well, I'll take that back. Water doesn't help plants out overnight. It takes a few days. You want to see his new shitter? Let me show you where we shit at now. Yeah, you go. Oh, there's my toilet paper I've told you about. You dumb idiot, I left it in the rain. I didn't think it was going to rain yesterday, okay, guys and gals? Here's my shitter. Everybody's shitter. This is a local shitter. It needs to be cleaned up a little bit, but that's old age, okay? Better than shitting a hole what we used to be shitting in. squatting over Hull. When he made that toilet, people looked at that and they said, even I said, man, that's a classic toilet. I don't think you can build a better bathroom. At least it doesn't stink anymore. I give that much credit. Well, till my next video, it'll be tomorrow or Friday. Let's talk about the marijuana I've been purchasing. I need to find a place to sit at. The marijuana prices here, for anybody that smokes marijuana. You're buying these little bags for $50 and $100 for a bag of just a little teeny gram bag, okay? That's all it is a gram. You can buy it for $5 or $10. Yes, or day before I bought some in a little town for $50 Jamaican dollars. Bought a few of them. Last me for a day. But I looked at some really shitty weed so far in Jamaica. Crap. Seeds, little teeny buds, and all stem. All of it stem. Lots of stems. This is just garbage now. Well, I saved the stems to go cook with, but I'm just gonna throw them away in the fields. So you buy all stem and no pot. It's about reality what you do. Now I was able to do one guy down a pound for 7,000 Jamaican dollars. And it was sticky, but it was compressed. That's the shit that I'm smoking right now. But it smells good. It was high quality, but they just compressed it so they can pack it and travel with it. And a lot of stems, little buds. I complained to the grower, showed him what to do in life. But this Friday, I'm gonna go try to purchase a lot. And I wanted to go to Orange Hill. And I know somebody has some growers up there. Know some growers, but he's telling me the real good shit is in Kingston and you gotta go through a middleman, and he tells me he's paying $15,000 for it and he's selling it for $30,000, and that's how much he told me. And I says, you know what, for $30,000 Jamaican dollars for a pound, I can get that cheaper in Mexico. I think I'm just going to go buy some high quality seeds, have them sent to me to Jamaica, and I just grow the shit. And that way I got good high quality weed, and for what the money they're fucking spending, I can get clones and seeds and not worry about marijuana the rest of my life. So I asked everybody, I says, does anybody have a mailing address I can send the marijuana seeds to? And they all looked at me like, we don't have addresses where we live at. And I said, say what? We don't have addresses, gringo. You'll have to have it sent to the post office. So we got a big dilemma. because I hate smoking joints of marijuana. I'd rather vaporize, and I need to buy me a heat gun. They don't sell heat guns in Jamaica, it looks like. So we got a bigger dilemma. I need a heat gun. I need high quality marijuana. The shit they're selling to me and the price they're selling it for. You know, all the videos I've seen of Jamaica was bragging about how good the marijuana was. Oh, high quality, best shit around the world. I'm just probably the best shit on the world, man. I'll tell you, I smoke some bad Mexican weed, all right? And I stay the fuck away from it. This shit looks like Mexican weed, but a little bit worse, because it comes with the stems. Mexico, they don't sell stems, they sell bud. I hate bitching about my marijuana in Jamaica, but god damn it. You know, I don't want you to look at my ugly face, but I want to tell you a little story. On earth, anything you've ever done before, or everything you do in life, somebody done it before you and taught you how to do it in life. Well, not me. Nobody's taught me the things that I do in life. But when I'm done in life, everybody else is going to follow me and what I've done in life and do what I've done in life. It's just going to be repetition. Like a person could go bloody clot, and everybody around Jamaica now says bloody clot, and it took one person to say that word. Now everybody uses that word, and they use it like what we would do with the fucking word fuck. You know, when you get pissed off, you go, fucking goddamn fucking son of a bitch, what the fuck is going on here, you fucking goddamn stupid fucking motherfuckers. Yeah, that word. Well, they go bloody clot this and bloody clot that. So if anybody ever calls you a blood clot, they're telling you that you're a fucking piece of shit on this earth, really. So, there's my little saying for the day. It takes one person to say one word, and everybody else is going to use that same word. Well, the word for the day, let me think up of a good word for everybody can use for the rest of their lives. Now, since I'm on the Queen of England's land, Jamaica, because Jamaica is owned by the Queen of England, like Jamaica owns United States, Canada, Mexico, and the rest of the world very soon. This is to everybody who worships the Queen and worships their government officials. A bloody killing for everybody on this fucked up earth. Yeah, a bloody killing. Maybe somebody will say that. Have a bloody life the rest of your life. Think you'll tell your friends that? Hey, when you leave them, you just tell them, go have a bloody life for the rest of your life. Yeah, I'm talking about you warmongers that need to be executed and be hung by the rope, same rope you fucking hung the king of Iraq with. Yeah, so let's all have a bloody life and a bloody killing for the rest of our lives. And let us start killing our government officials, including the CIA and the FBI and the Illuminati. Yeah, let us all have a bloody life like how they're having a bloody life right now in all the wars for a new world order. A one world government, a one world religion, a one world tongue. But let us all not forget the one world currency we will all be spending one day on this fucked up earth. The Illuminati, the Skull and Bones, or the Freemasonaries, and whatever the fuck you want to call those fucking child molesters. Yeah, go have a blood killing today. Enjoy life. You only have one life to live before you be killed by them. So, go have a bloody life for the rest of your life, warmongers. Because one day you're going to be seeing your own blood coming from you. And it's going to be too late. And you won't be able to have time to do anything about it. Except see your eyes become complete darkness in front of your face.